Have you ever wondered why airplanes don't have parachutes for passengers? Even if they did, would it be helpful enough to save all the passengers who lost their lives in previous airplane crashes? In this video, we will discuss the idea of Igor Sikorsky to equip airplanes with parachutes for passengers. And despite the fact that many other aviation experts agreed with him, why this idea was not implemented, instead was rejected by all the commercial airline industries worldwide. So keep watching our channel, The Curious Corner. Since 1970, almost 84,000 people have died due to aviation accidents. Whether if it's the pilot who misjudged a situation, a mechanical failure, severe weather, or a bird colliding with a plane, there are always innocent people who pay the price. The high altitude and speed of airplanes cause catastrophic structural damage in crashes, often resulting in fuel leaks that lead to fires or explosions, making it nearly impossible for most passengers to survive. But what if the passengers had the option to grab a parachute and jump to safety? It seems like a no-brainer, but the reality is a bit more complicated. Parachutes have been around since the early 20th century and have been successfully used by the military personnel and stunt jumpers. However, the dynamics of a military jump and a commercial airline emergency are vastly different. Commercial airplanes cruise at altitudes of around 35,000 feet, with speeds of about 500 to 600 miles per hour, which is much higher than an average skydiving drill. Jumping from such heights and speed would require specialized training and equipment to survive the initial freefall, let alone deploying a parachute safely. Using a parachute isn't as simple as pulling a cord. Passengers would need extensive training to handle the complexities of a high-altitude jump. Opening an airplane door at high altitude and speed is extremely dangerous due to the differential pressure inside and outside the cabin. Additionally, the physical act of exiting the aircraft safely while in motion would be very difficult, especially in an emergency, severe turbulence, or other critical failures. It would be nearly impossible for passengers to safely exit and deploy parachutes. Furthermore, parachutes are bulky and heavy. Equipping a commercial airliner with parachutes for every passenger would significantly add to the weight and reduce the space available for passengers and cargo. Parachutes aren't cheap either. The cost of purchasing, maintaining, and regularly inspecting hundreds of parachutes for every flight would be astronomical. Airlines would need to pass these costs into passengers, making air travel much more expensive and flights less efficient. Alternatively, modern airplanes are equipped with numerous safety features like emergency lights, ramps, and oxygen masks. Pilots are trained to handle emergencies and land the plane safely even in challenging conditions. Furthermore, a passenger plane pilot is not allowed to leave the aircraft mid-air using a parachute. Either he'll save the plane or die trying. Therefore, parachutes are not available for pilots also. And at last, most commercial aviation accidents happen during takeoff and landing, where parachutes would not be useful. The scenarios in which parachutes could be effectively used are extremely rare. Therefore, this idea was ignored by all airline industries worldwide.